Yes, people, it's stupid o'clock in the morning. It is 6:15. Joe's been up all night. This guy's an absolute madman coming, but he's came over nice and early. We're going to get a full day of filming in. A lot's been going on. We've been a bit quiet on YouTube. But plan this morning is we're going to run to the gym, which I'll reveal what the gym is in a second because not a lot of people will know. We're going to run to the gym. I think it's a 12-kilometre route. We're 1 week out from Hyrox Manchester, which I'm stupid still doing because I've had that much on. But we're going to just do a little simple Hyrox run, which I do commonly just about like four or five weeks out. And I'll be trying to put this one in. 5 minutes run at about threshold pace, just a bit faster than Hyrox pace. 3.5 minutes float, 8 rounds. Typical kind of Hyrox setup. Run for 4 or 5 minutes. Station state about 3.5 minutes. Repeat that for 8 rounds. But this one's going to be on the hills because we're just literally running in the dark. But this time I have my kit crew, which is obviously going to be Joe. And I've even invested in one of these things, which is, oh, that's my timer to say that I need to leave. Got to be organised. This thing, which I'm going to look like an idiot wearing, however, see how bright this is. Oh, call me Nick Bear, the Geordie Nick Bear, there we go. I look like an idiot, but repping Fizz Rig, going to get it running. Joe's going to film some content. Got a big group in this morning. Yeah, it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to this. Let's go and get it. Inner David Gordon's coming out. A lot of people these days make a lot of excuses for things. Got no time, got too much going on. Obviously, yeah, I know there's a lot of struggle with kids and work and stuff, but just gotta get up and get at it. Joe's the same. He's up early, working. Just gotta put the time in. Obviously, recovery's a big part of it, but just get up early. Get up at 4 o'clock, get your session in, set yourself up for the day. You thank yourself. A lot of people leave things too late in the day. They get tired, they've got things on the evening, and that's their excuse. Just get up early and get after it. We've got part one done of the day. Anyway, what did we do? We did, my Strava keeps on messing up. It keeps on giving me like 2 minute kilometers. Yeah, apparently I got a 2 minute 58 kilometer at one point, which is definitely not true at all. But probably average on my 5 minute efforts, looking like a 140, 130 to one, highest one was 150. 4:30 to 4:50 pace. So I'm very slow, but it was very heavy. But yeah, 13K in the bank. Now I'm gonna get set up. We're at the secret location, currently known as District 5. Soon to be rebranded, but we'll talk about that a little bit later. But we've got a morning group on in an hour. Gotta get set up, get some food. Joe's gonna get some more caffeine in him. Yeah, we'll take you for the rest of the day. All right, let's get this stuff done. The check, I don't have like blueberries or meat. You know, that's the one thing I worry about when I have frozen blueberries is getting blue stuff on here. Right, people, anyway, we're getting my breakfast in. PT Life, coffee flask, double espresso, and overnight oats. Got to be prepared. But I'll walk you through what the plan is. We've got 18 people in this, I think 18 people in this class. So this is the layout. Saturdays is always a good partner or like a threesome group workout. 6 stations. We've got the assault bikes as part number one. There's a little twist on this one. We've got dumbbells laid out. We've got some of the RX weights, the 22.5s going all the way down to like 10s. We've got a mixed group of people coming in here. The whole time, people have got to be holding one of the dumbbells, or at least two of the dumbbells. One person's got to hold two dumbbells at once. So groups of three, one person will be working 150 calories on the assault bike. One person's going to be holding the dumbbells. The other person's just going to rest, going to rotate through that. Then you're going to a little 3 rounds for time. We've got, split the reps up however you want. 30 front rack reverse lunges, 20 dumbbell renegade rows, that's each side as well, and then 10 dual dumbbell thrusters. Work through that in your threes however you want. Then you're onto the row. I think it's 2K on the row we got. Ooh, 3K, I'll put 3K in, that'll be a nasty one. 3K on the rower, blast that out. Then to another little 3 rounds, hang snatches, burpees over dumbbells and push-ups. And then my favorite exercise, of course, has to be wall balls in there. So 150 wall balls, 9 kilos for the lads and 6 for the ladies. But I'm gonna finish my breakfast up. Joe's gonna get the drone out and get some good content. I'm gonna get highly caffeinated for this one. It's gonna be good energy. And then afterwards, we're gonna hit up a little Hyrox sim, but just the ergs. Sorry, just the rock zone stuff. So full day of training, full day of eating, full day of working, getting it done.
Construct the air and all that brings. And oxidation is the compromise you own. But this is beginning to feel like the dog wants a bone. Say
la, 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 la. Okay, ready? Morning. How are we? There he is. Right, this is the guy, he wants to come on camera, come on. Did you know he's been on Dragon's Den, by the way? I know, did you know?
Where's hair and makeup, man?
You look good, mate, don't worry.
Oh, mate, I was up at 6, ready for this.
Oh, yeah. Before you fight, and then you fall, so fire your deeds. What's 17? Right, come on, you lot, get yourself in, because I think this is everyone here. Team warm up. Everybody must hold a straight arm plank in a nice circle.
We're gonna make a little oblique circle in this little area.
Yeah. I'm gonna go around for 2 minutes and make a little bit of a Mexican wave of burpees. Now this is gonna judge your time. We're gonna test these out a little bit. Everyone's gonna be in this position. When one person starts, we're gonna go chest to floor burpee, jump up, back down, hold position. And we're gonna go around in a circle for 2 minutes. Anybody breaks, punishment is 10 team burpees. That's the first thing. 2, 1, go. Good pressure. Right, and the next one. There we go. Go on, Jack, keep those knees up for me. That's it, go. Next one,
exploding, devoted to crushing the broken and sharpening the souls.
Eternalized,
objectified, set your sights so high. But this is beginning to feel like the both of us
are
loose from the lever. Never mind, death professor.
That's the only round you can get. You're going to get 2 rounds in that happen.
Your victim flies so high. All to catch a bird's eye full of who's next. Never you mind, death professor.
So when we get back to Dan, just to confuse everyone, we're going to go back the other way. So Dan goes. Ah! Right, I'm back. Go on.
My stress is better. Your fiction flies so high. I could use a doctor. Who's sick? Who's next? Never you mind. Death professor. Electrified. My love is better.
2, 1. Let's go. Come on, man. Really love that.
Never beg for a pardon. Cash in for
the lads. Doing it in a doubles. Just two. Everyone else is doing it in threes. These two are doing it in two. RX as well. Let's go, lads.
We keep playing with fire.
Go however you want. Nice.
Knowing it's a dangerous game. Got some black market rumors. Body with a cold hand. Crimes no one gets away with. Some sins you can't atone for. Like gold you trade your soul for. Had enough but gotta have more. We keep playing with fire.
Nice.
I still got those reps. Knowing it's a dangerous game. I'm always smashing them. Yeah, we keep playing with fire. They can smell it from a mile away. So we keep playing with fire.
Dumbbells over. Well done, lads. Get them on the rack. Good shift. Very good shift. All right, you put them down. You can put them down now. Take them home. Shopping bags. Go on, everyone. Let's finish it. Hey. Well, 46. Hello. Nice, Donna, keep going. Come on, final few reps. What you've got? 10 each. Oh, there you go, last one. Come on, lads. How long you got? Done. Well done, lads. Good shift, that. Well done. Excellent work, everybody. Well done. Good shift this morning. My team to get the second session in, jint to ourselves. Good little group this morning. The plan is I'll do a little bit of strength stuff because I haven't really lifted a lot of weights recently, just from time and stuff. It's just when I get an hour, I'm just in, skiing, rowing, running, just getting Hyrox stuff. And so we'll do a little bit of lower body power, do some power cleans, keeping the strength volume relatively low on the legs just because I'm doing that much volume doing anything else. Bit of upper body, we'll do some bench press and pull-ups. Probably just like a 5x5 of each, fly through that. And then we'll do a rock zone Hyrox. So 1K ski, 50 meter sled push at pro weights, 50 meter sled pull at pro weights, 80 meters burpee bro jumps, 1K row, 200 meter farmer's carry at the 32 kgs, 100 meters of lunges with a sandbag, which is definitely more than 30 kilos, but we'll do it anyway. And I'm gonna go 110 wall balls just for those extra 10, and at 12 kilos, because I want to stay on the 12s until my first race, so that 9 kilo feels quite light. Yeah, it's going to be fun. Legs are quite heavy from this morning, so we've got to get it in. Let's go. Right, and I've still got 100 for 3 and is on a power clean. It's been a while since I've done them. We'll just build up to 100, see if I've got 100. Wait. Trying to waffle for 5 minutes. Anyway, session done. To be fair, the main thing at the minute for me isn't my training, even though I've got a lot competitions wise. Obviously Manchester next week, Glasgow in 6 weeks time, and then the World Champs. My main focus is this, which a lot of people are probably thinking, Brennan, why are you training out of a different gym? What's happened to the home gym? What's happened with YouTube? Because it's been about 3 or 4 weeks by the time this video comes out that since I've done something. But pretty much over the Christmas period when we're off, I got the opportunity to come and check out this place, which is currently known as District 5, soon to be rebranded, potentially to the name Process, which is something that I believe in. Believing in the process, focusing on those steps that get to an end goal rather than the actual, just focusing on the end goal of, right, I want to be 5 kilograms lighter, right, I want to be have a six pack, this, that, and the other. Focus on the process and that will get you that to that end goal. So this opportunity came, support the previous owners, seen the situation they were in, came and checked the place out, was surprised how big the unit was for being literally 10 minutes down from where I live. So it's an ideal location, predominantly group training, which is something I really want to push. I think for people who struggle with motivation, training in that group environment is a massive thing, bouncing off each other, the energy, like even if I've had a long day of PT and I get to the evening classes, 5:30, 6:30, which is what we're running at the minute, get to that point, the energy comes in here, blasting the music, people pushing themselves, trying to encourage each other. That environment really motivates people. We've got a little like leaderboard, a bit of competition system going on here as well. But yeah, the opportunity came and I wrote down literally 2 days before New Year's Day, wrote my little goals down. One of them was to compete more, because that's one thing that I love, and obviously showcasing it through YouTube, through Instagram. The second thing was, say fuck it a bit more and get out of my comfort zone. And then literally 2 days later, this opportunity comes up and I literally just said to myself, I've been doing the same thing, obviously building my online business. My PT business was kind of at its cap. I couldn't really PT anybody more from my garage as well as doing my online business. It got to the point where I was like, well, I'm 26. I might as well push myself out the comfort zone. The same thing I say to my clients, keep pushing yourself out of those comfort zones, where it's in work, where it's in fitness, trying competitions, trying new types of sports, whatever it is. So I just said, you know what, I'm 26, I might as well take a leap of faith, go for it. I've always got my old career to fall back on, doing what I was doing. And yeah, we're here. So literally, it's been officially a week today since I've been the owner of this facility, the owner of the gym. And I've loved it so far. It's been long hours, it's been hard work, but we're just building. Early days, so nothing crazy is happening to the gym at the minute. We're looking to get some upgrades, bits of kit. I've already had some bits of kit. We are going to do a rebrand. We will do a big open day, which Joe will obviously film, take you along on the way. But I want this little YouTube series, which me and Joe are going to work together over the next year or so, getting at least one video out a month, potentially pushing it more and more down the line. Probably going to call it The Process, or Process, because that's what this is all about. Just document the journey of the growth of this gym. We're going to try and get this upstairs a bit nice for the members, get a little kitchen sort facility where we get coffees, a place for people to chill, lay out the gym a bit different. Going to try and do some in-house competitions, Hyrox competitions, CrossFit, which is already a big part of this gym. It's a very big functional fitness gym. We'll do big meetups for like competitions like Murph, or like workouts like Murph, CrossFit Open, Hyrox Full Sims, potentially competing in other things like athletics and stuff down the line. But I just want to build a massive community of like-minded people in this gym, people who are wanting to push themselves, let this be their escape. Because obviously we have a lot of stuff that we mentally deal with, the stresses of life, kids, work life, the stresses of constantly having to succeed, which I think everyone falls under pressure. I fall under the pressure to it as well. Yeah, I want this to be a safe space and build a community, and we'll see where it goes. But we're based at White House Farm. It is just up the A1 on the way to Morbeth. If you were, I'm just in Crampton, so I'm not too far away. It's 10 minutes from Crampton, 15 minutes max from Newcastle. If you want to come in, try the facility out. We're doing open day passes. We do open sessions as well. If you want to book a free taster, we're doing that as well. But you can just message me on Instagram, email the business. We're going to get a new website set up. There's a lot to do, pretty much. But if you want to come up, train with me, meet me, just drop me a message on Instagram at Brendan Pearson Fitness or the gym's Instagram, which is currently District 5. Yeah, I'm just really excited for the future. There might be more business content and less about me, because what this place is about is the community, is the members. But yeah, I'm looking forward to documenting the journey. That's a little bit from me. Thank you for everybody who watched this full video, maybe a long one. I apologise, Joe, for keeping you so long, because I can't waffle. There's loads of things I want to get done. But the man behind the camera is going to produce some good content over the next few years, hopefully, and we'll see how this business goes. But I'm still doing Hyrox coaching. I'm still doing the online stuff. I'm still going to train myself. But yeah, this is going to be my baby, hopefully, and we're going to grow it. I want you to take yous along with me. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video. Over and out.